Ladies and gentlemen, Keith from iRepair Autos. Today I'm going to be bringing you something a little different. This is the first video of the diagnostic series from Mercedes using the icarsoft hardware. I'm going to show you how to troubleshoot, diagnose your problems so that you can know exactly what's wrong, just like the Mercedes master mechanics do. Stay tuned.
Be sure to subscribe if you're not yet a subscriber. Once you've subscribed, be sure to click on that bell so that you get notified every single time I release a video.
All right, after you've put the key into position 2, you'll then select the diagnose button. Say okay, choose bend, say okay. I have a 164M class, I'm going to choose that and say okay. You choose yours. I'm going to say gasoline engine, left hand steering. Go down to the 164, 156, ML350, say okay. Automatic, say okay. At this point, it's going to load up all of the hint menus from 1 to 47 in this case. So it's going to take a little bit. It's at 7, 8, 9. So at this time, we're going to choose the ME9.7 six-cylinder because it's a six-cylinder. So we're going to go down to the six-cylinder. We're going to say OK. And what we're going to do, we're going to go down to the actual values and say OK. We're going to go down to test engine at idle speed. We're going to say OK. Now, before we start the engine, let's take a look. 44.8 degrees Celsius for the coolant. The battery's at 11.9. Air conditioning is off. If I was to turn that on, it would come on. Engine speed is at 0.1 or 0 RPMs per, revolutions per minute. We're going to go down. Intake manifold pressure. Intake manifold changeover. Everything is off at this point, okay, because the engine is off. So we're going to hit down again until we see the voltage readings of the O2 sensors. So I'm going to hit down one more time. Engine speed, gas, downstream, and hit down again. So now we see that the component 616 O2 sensor before the TWCs, catalytic converters, they're operational, and it's set to no, it's not operational, the engine is off. So before the cats, these are the values before the cats. Now after the cats, because the ignition is on, it's at 1.64 volts for the right, hit down, and 1.46 value for the left. These are also not operational because they're off. So we want to write that down. Okay, 1.46 for the O2 sensors after the catalytic converters. So let's go back up to the top menu, all the way up by hitting up. All right. And we're at the top where it says temperature, coolant. Notice how battery voltage is moving around. Now I'm going to start the engine. And notice that the values are now changing. Okay, temperature is going to start to rise. I'm going to hit the down arrow. Intake manifold pressure is there. But let's jump back down using the down arrow key to the O2 sensors. Before the catalytic converter, those values are still set to no. They're not operational yet. The engine isn't warm enough, but most importantly, the catalytic converters aren't warm enough. And now we see that those values on the O2 sensors after the cats are still at 1.46, all right? So we're going to just let the engine warm up for a bit while looking at these values, 1.46. And the catalytic converters are not operational yet. So this is important to see. When the engine is cold, catalytic converter is cold, and it takes a tremendous amount of heat to warm these things up, but once they get hot, they're hot. So the O2 sensors are not yet operational. It's not reading anything. The catalytic converter, sorry, are not operational at this point. 1.46 volts. Our engine idle speed is moving around. Our exhaust temperatures are starting to climb. And this is downstream of the right catalytic converter and the left catalytic converter. So those values are going to continue to climb. As the engine warms up. Temperature of coolant is 57.6 degrees Celsius. Let's go back down to and I'm making the engine race a little bit so that these catalytic converters will warm up. Lambda control values 1.22, 1.23. Now you see the catalytic converters are now operational. Yes, before the CATs, the O2 sensors are reading and they're 1.46 volts. O2 sensors after the CATs are still at 1.46 volts and they're still not operational. So we're in the pre-operational phase for the O2 sensors after the CAT, and they'll become operational momentarily as the CATs warm up. But the ones before the CATs are operational and they're steady at 1.46 volts. Left and right operational. I'm going back up. Exhaust temperature is right around 212 degrees Celsius for left and right. They're kind of still in the warm-up phase, getting hotter. I just gave the car a little bit of gas there. I'm going to race it again. Let's go back down. Check on the O2 sensors after the catalytic converters. They're not operational yet. And their voltage that they're reading is 1.46 volts. Okay, so we're looking at the exhaust gas temperature downstream of the catalytic converters. Those are right around 410 degrees Celsius at this point and climbing. So I'm going to press the down arrow and go back and look at the O2 sensors after the CAT. See, they're not operational yet. The ones before the CAT are operational because it's reading in, and there it goes. They just became operational. So let's go back up and see the temperature. Right around 425 degrees Celsius, those downstream catalytic converters became operational. So let's go back down. So the downstream catalytic converters, right and left, are operational, and their voltage is right around 1.66. So you could expect anything between 1.64 and 1.67, 1.68. when they're in operational mode. That's the voltage that they give off. Once they're detecting that the catalytic converter is now hot enough and it starts to burn those combustible gases, what you find is that the car goes into pre-warm-up mode, and before those downstream catalytic converters are reading a hot enough temperature, the engine goes into this special mode where it burns this these exhaust gases, And then once the car is hot enough and the catalytic converters are hot enough, they can burn efficiently. Then they switch over into this lean, clean mode of cleaning up the exhaust. So the catalytic converters are good. But the test was to see if the O2 sensors were good. And there are 4 oxygen sensors on this car, 2 before the catalytic converters and 2 after. The 2 after are now operational, reading in 1.66 volts for the left and 1.67 volts on average for the right. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, this is what you do to troubleshoot your O2 sensors and get an idea of what your cats are doing. Very great idea to do this. Get these values written down in your logbook before there's an issue, if you don't have an issue yet, so that when you do have an issue, you will say, hey, when everything was working, those values after warm-up were at 1.66 volts for the downstream O2 sensors after the catalytic converter. You also want to keep in mind and write down the temperature values for catalytic converters as well. See how those are right around 506 degrees, 508 degrees Celsius. So you want to write those down, because as catalytic converters get clogged up, if you have, you know, poor maintenance schedules, oil changes are not done on time, etc., these things can get clogged up, or if the engine is running poorly. So these are the values of everything in terms of catalytic converters left and right, the exhaust gas temperature, and the voltage. O2 sensor voltage after the TWCs, a 1.04 volts right at this point. So right after they warm up, they're at 1.66, and as the car, you know, settles down, stabilizes, they go right back down to 1.6 volts. All right, so these are the values that you need to keep in mind once everything is operational. If you had a bad oxygen sensor, and one bad one, one good one, you might see one at 1.6 volts, which is within range, and then you might see one at 0.0 volts or a really high voltage. If that's the case, then you can be sure that that oxygen sensor is not operational. These O2 sensors tend to follow each other in voltage very closely once the car is up and running.
As always, everyone, don't forget to like, share, subscribe to my channel if you find these videos helpful. What that does, it pushes my videos up in the search results so that other Mercedes owners, drivers, do-it-yourselfers can find them easier. Thanks and peace out.